a lot of different tribal leaders inside Iraq. We have to remember Iraq is a very fragmented society with a lot of disparate different groups who are trying to sort of work together. So some of the local leaders of those groups and various other officials, sort of low line officials of some organizations over there. So we're talking about some of some people of importance, not from the actual government, but also a lot of Kurdish officials over there, Kurdish people from the area of Kurdistan where the conference was taking place in Erbil. And we have to remember that Kurdistan historically has had a much better relationship with Israel than Iraq. They do enjoy some level of autonomy over there. We've seen in the past, for instance, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said that the Kurds deserve independence when the referendum was taking place over there, and there was a chance that that would happen. So that's also something to take into consideration, although there were also people who were from Iraq proper. These weren't only Kurds, even if that's where the conference was taking place. And it is something, though, that is very positive from the Israeli perspective to see such a large conference with so many people over there coming out and saying openly that they want to normalize ties with Israel, speaking positively of the Jewish community that used to exist in Iraq, and sort of lamenting the fact that that entire community abandoned Iraq back in the early 1950s, and wanting to sort of renew links with the descendants of Iraqi Jews. So a positive development, but again, we also have to note that the Iraqi government sort of condemned this conference and that it's still illegal under Iraqi law to have connections with Zionists. So the next step that they want to take there was actually to have direct conversations with Israelis, between Israelis and Iraqis, is essentially something that is illegal under Iraqi law. And of course, the Iranians have a presence in Iraq as well that they
want. Central government is of a different mind than this group that came together, as you mentioned, that heavy influence of Iran potentially on the Baghdad government.
Right, so this is something that's been ongoing now for years, the sort of encroachment of Iran on Iraqi sovereignty. Iraq is a mixed Sunni Shia country. Iran, of course, is leading the Shia axis in the Middle East and have a lot of influence inside Iraq, and they certainly will not look kindly on the idea that people in Iraq want to normalize ties with Israel, though even without the Iranian involvement, we're seeing that the government has come out and condemned this. And just an anecdote, remember the beauty queen, Sarah Idan, the Iraqi beauty queen, who took a picture with the Israeli beauty queen in the Miss Universe and had so much backlash and ended up leaving the country. That just shows you where a lot of the public opinion is in Iraq, and it's not most of it where this conference is, but it's definitely a very positive start from the Israeli perspective.